and welcome to today's video. Today's video is a highly requested one because all of you are always praising me about the way I'm groomed, and I want to say a big fat thank you to you for that. So in today's video, I'm going to give you 5 tips on what you should do to keep yourself completely groomed all the time. This is what I follow, and hopefully you like these and will follow them too. As I always say, let's dive right into it. Okay, step number one. To make sure your skin is always feeling and looking healthy, do like a weekly exfoliating process. I personally am absolutely loving the exfoliating scrubs from the BeautyCo, and I feel like you will too. They come in various categories, fragrances, not flavors. Fragrances, I want to say, right from chocolate to strawberry and so many others. There are many other brands in the market that do it too. They're my personal favorite right now, that's why I'm just mentioning them. But you just make sure you exfoliate your skin on like a weekly basis, at least if not twice a week, depending on your schedule, because your skin will feel healthy, will look healthy, and I feel like shiny, smooth skin is something we all strive for. Grooming tip number 2 is about hair removal. Now, I know most of us like our hair to be absolutely not there on our bodies. My go-to hair removal method has been shaving for as long as I can remember, at least the last 4 to 5 years, I think. I actually did a whole I'm new to shaving journey kind of a series with you, and I did like a few blog posts for you guys where I was new to shaving, trying shaving for the first time, and what I thought the results were turning out for me like. I'll add a link to those blog posts down below, so make sure you guys go check that out, because right from that being my first impressions to today, it is my go-to method of hair removal. The shaving blade that I choose to use is the Gillette Venus Breeze. For me, I feel like when I'm shaving, I don't want to be stressed about cutting myself or accidentally wounding myself, but the Gillette Venus Breeze doesn't give me that stress at all. It is so easy to maneuver, going all over my body. It does really well with the curves of a woman. And I'm a wet shaver, I don't really recommend dry shaving.
And with the help of these 3 steps, I feel like my shaving process is perfectly done. Step 1, I always make sure I wet my skin. Next, I shave. And step 3, to go ahead and give a nice smooth finish to my skin, I go ahead and add some moisturizer to my routine.
I actually even opted just for self-shaving before I got married. I know a lot of women opt for alternate methods, but this has been my go-to method for as long as I became a convert. So you guys are gonna find all the links down below. Make sure to take a look. Grooming tip number 3. Now, you guys are always being really nice to me about all the love on my nails. I want to tell you that the only thing I do to take care of my nails or my hands or my toes is that I make sure I get monthly manicures, pedicures. If you are traveling, after I'm traveling, I always make it a point to get myself a manicure or a pedicure. I feel like that's just the basic thing everybody must do, because when your nails are chipped, or if you have broken nails, or for that matter, if you have chipped nail paint, it doesn't look nice and it completely takes away from the grooming factor of your look. Grooming tip number 4. This one's for the hair. You guys know I'm always talking about making sure I oil my hair at least once a week. Apart from oiling my hair, I think another thing you should definitely try are hair masks or deep conditioning, whatever works for you. Hair gets really frizzy super easily. God knows we've all had Monica moments from Friends, right? Anybody remember season 9 Monica going like crazy with her hair? So to make sure that you avoid moments like that, please always make sure to either try hair masks, hair oiling regularly, or for that matter, something as simple as leaving a little bit of leave-in conditioner in your hair can stop your hair from looking unruly or crazy frizzy. And grooming tip number 5. Last but definitely not the least, make sure you always smell nice. Body odor can be a real put off, and if you're someone who tends to sweat, use deos, use perfumes, whatever works for you. Just make sure you always smell nice and pleasant, because it doesn't matter how nice you look, if you're not gonna smell nice, it's gonna be a put off no matter where you are. Okay, so there you go. I've given you guys my go-to 5 grooming tips. I really hope this helps. If you guys want me to do other series similar to this on 5 tips for various other things, let me know down below in the comments. I hope that by now you guys have hit the subscribe button, that you've hit that bell button, and that you'll keep coming back for more videos. A huge thank you to Gillette for partnering with me on this video. I will see you guys in the next one. Mwah.